Welcome back to the 16th Marketing Conclave, organized by IMEI and powered by Z5. We now move on to our next case study for the day, Unlock the Power of AI for Fashion Supply Chain. And to present it, we have here with us Dr. Vikas Raikar, STSM and Manager, IBM Research AI for Supply Chain, IBM India, and Mr. Jai Krishnan Hari, Program Director, IBM Research, IBM India. Over to you, Mr. Jai Krishnan.
Yeah, thank you, Srinivas. Good afternoon, everyone. So today we will be talking about the power of AI, how it can unlock the fashion supply chain and make it more efficient. Before that, I just want to highlight three kind of headwinds which are facing the industry. One, if you see what we call as the changing consumer trends. The brands, if you see the fashion brands, they're trying to be more younger day by day. And what used to be, for example, two-season kind of experience in the past, like a spring, summer, autumn, winter, now it's kind of moving to kind of 12 seasons. Right? Every 4 weeks is a season. Because of the changes in the consumer taste, the retailers and the fashion houses are under tremendous pressure, right, to get to the right product to the right kind of consumer at the right time. So one important kind of change is the whole consumer preferences. The second one, if you look at, is how technology, for example, is kind of spreading. And a recent IBM study kind of said that around 90% of data within the enterprise is dark data. What it means by dark data is data that is actually acquired, processed by the enterprises, but they are not used for analytics or for, you know, different purposes. So the technology kind of invasion and spread kind of driving into the chase, both feeding into each other. That's the second important change which is happening. Third important change, if you see, is on the sustainability. Consumers are becoming more conscious about what they consume. And if you see, for example, fashion industry is one of the biggest contributor to kind of the pollution. And roughly in 2019, around 2.1 billion kind of quantity of greenhouse gas emission kind of was attributed to the fashion industry. So overproduction and the inventory overhang, all are an important contributor to the kind of the whole pollution trend. And how can fashion retailers and houses look at reducing their inventory, having a right kind of amount of inventory in their stores, appropriate assortment plan? These are some of the questions that are facing the industry now. What we are trying to do at IBM Research is, how can we address some of these challenges using AI across the value chain? So that's the case study that we want to talk about and present today. And I will let my colleague, Dr. Vikas Raikar, take you through the case study. Over to you, Vikas.
Hey, thanks, Jay. So my name is Vikas. So I think I represent IBM Research, and I'm going to talk to you about a case study we did with a client. I think overall our project is called as AI for Supply Chain, but for the past 2 years, there's a little bit sharper focus on the unique problems in the fashion supply chain. Yeah. So, but today I'll just talk about one specific aspect of this problem. Yeah. So again, as Jay mentioned, I think the starting point for most of what we want to discuss is that every fashion retailer has this problem of dead unsold inventory. Yeah. So despite having a lot of internal historical sales data, yeah, for most fashion houses, only around 50 to 60% of the products really sell well. And the things that don't sell well, either you do a very lot of markdown, or you send it to second-hand shops, or if you're very brand conscious, then you even end up liquidating the inventory. Yeah? So at the core of it, if you want to understand why is there excess unsold inventory at the end of every season, so it's essentially at a very high level, we can think of it as the mismatch between supply and the demand, right? Essentially, either the inventory is overproduced or underproduced, but essentially there is a big impedance between what is needed, the demand, and what is there in supply. Yeah? And some of the assets what we talk about in the project essentially try to do so that the right product is at the right location at the right time and the right time at the right price. Yeah? But one of the reason the mismatch between demand and supply is sort of can be attributed to what we call as inaccurate demand forecast. Yeah? And that is what this case study is going to be about. Yeah? So what is demand forecast? Yeah? So demand forecast essentially means I would like for any retailer, right? But in this case, we're looking at a fashion retailer. So I would like to forecast the demand for this blouse at a particular store for the next season. Yeah? So for example, you consider this blouse, I would like to see for the next season, what can be the demand or how many units that a person will, people will buy at this product, for example, at a store in Phoenix Market City. Yeah? So once you have this sort of a spatio-temporal hyper-local demand forecast, rest of the supply chain planning falls into place. Yeah? But why is sort of demand forecast hard? And it's exactly a problem for fashion, right? And because we cannot do an accurate demand forecast in fashion, that's why this inventory piles up. Yeah? And the reason why it is a hard problem in fashion, because fashion is a little bit unique where every season, 80% of the products that you're going to launch are new products. Yeah? So if you look at classical retail, right? Take example, a can of Pepsi. Yeah? So it has been sold for years and years for the past 15, maybe more than that, right? And then you have your historical time series data. Based on that, you can extrapolate and say, okay, for next season or next month or next year, the demand for Pepsi would be so much, right? But look at in fashion, for example, this particular dress, right? Think that this dress has never been done before, right? So it's a product which is newly created just for this season. And this is extremely an acute problem because fashion is heavily trend driven. Yeah? And when 80% of the products are new, how do you go about even forecasting what would be the demand for a particular product, right? Because to do an efficient supply chain planning, I would like to know the demand for this product. Yeah? And the way we solve is by what we call as an attribute-based demand forecasting, right? So while I cannot, while for example, this particular top was never done before, but I have done something like this before, right? I've done something like this shoulder line. I've done something in this color. I've done something in this sleeve length, yeah? So what we do is we take this product, break it down into a bunch of attributes or metadata, and then we essentially try to forecast the model using an AI model, which actually stitches all these attributes together and gets you a demand forecast, right? And this is one way we get rid of this problem that even though there is no explicit historical reference, we can leverage on the historical data for all the attributes. Then based on the attributes of this product, give us still an accurate demand forecast for this product. So that was the first challenge we had to face. Yeah? The second problem we wanted to address was, okay, I can tell you, okay, this product will sell around 50 units next season, right? Of course, again, this is a black box machine learning model, AI model that we give to a merchandiser. But what we kind of realized is that unless we make this prediction explainable, the adoption from merchandisers and designers was very low. Yeah? So what in this model we went to, we took the same forecasting model and made it explainable using concepts from explainable AI. So this would now give an explanation to a merchandiser on why this particular forecast was made. Yeah? Specifically for this example, I think this one, the model forecasted that the sell-through rate of this product was around 60%, 0.59. Yeah? A sell-through rate essentially means if there was 100 in the inventory, 60 units sold. Yeah? And it is now trying to attribute, trying to explain why was this 60%, right? Why was it higher than the average of around 2%, which most of them had, right? Again, the metric we're looking at something called as fourth week sell-through rate, and there's a little bit of details. But it gets you a reasons for why it thinks, what are the reasons why, which are making it push higher, and the reasons why it's pushing it negative influence, right? So for example, here you would say that the reason why this product will sell well for this particular season is mainly the neckline being off shoulder. Yeah. And there are not many negative influences, but I think most of them are positive influences. That would be the first reason. The second reason would be because it is a cropped length. Yeah. And just to stress that this notion of explainability is a very product or SKU level. That means, so if the same product, right, I look at it here, this was sold in spring, summer 2019. If I now sell it in autumn, winter 2019, so the model gives you a completely different forecast and a different explanation. Yeah? And for example, earlier neckline being off shoulder was a positive influence. Now neckline being off shoulder is a negative influence. Yeah? And this is again, the insights are coming from the AI model, but it's a little bit fairly obvious in this case because autumn winter 2019 is winter, and maybe off shoulders probably don't sell well in winters, right? And this other kind of insight it is picking up. So that kind of segues into the next tool, which is sort of what if analysis, right? You said, okay, neckline off shoulder had a negative influence on the sales, but now the designer can come and ask, or the merchandiser can come and ask, what if I had changed the neckline? So this helps us to do this what if simulations, where you can actually iterate over different necklines and see what would have been the sell through rate if I made the neckline from off shoulder to say a polo neckline or a crew neck or a U neck, right? And you can do that in terms of any attributes, either be discount, fabric, color saturation, etc. Okay, so now the next part is essentially, I think this is sort of again building up the story. First, I said, why was the demand forecast made? First is forecast the demand. Second is, why was this forecast made? Third is the what if I change a particular attribute? And finally, I think the final stage, what we do is something what we call as algorithmic product design. So here are what we suggest some minor changes to the product that you can make to potentially increase your sell-through rate. Yeah. So here in this case, it suggests that if I want to go from 0.58, which is a 58% sell-through rate, to 73% sell-through rate, you can do this by two changes. You can either make the neckline from off-shoulder to crew neck and make the color slightly lighter. Yeah. Again, these are suggestions coming from an AI model, but of course the designers sort of use them in their workflow and then take a call. Okay, you're suggesting making a crew neck, okay, I'll go with it. Maybe the color, I still like it, I can still keep it, but that helps you sort of to iterate your design choices and still have a forecast, what would be the suggested demand forecast for this for the next season. So these are some of the core tools, but there's also another AI tool that was embedded in this case today, which sort of the designers found pretty useful, which is essentially what we call as a visual search tool, where you take a particular product and the designer would like to know, have I done something like this in the past, right? Again, fashion is highly visual, so you cannot go and search for these attributes. What here we look at it is that we purely compare the product images based on the image similarity surface of what are the other similar products in my catalog. And there is also a pink bar on top of it, which shows you, okay, this was the sell-through rate of that particular product. So I think that was roughly a small teaser into how sort of modern AI tools can help you to do very accurate, explainable demand forecasts for new products. Yeah. But overall, what is the project is titled? I'll step back a little bit. I think overall, what we are trying to do is to enable merchandisers, buyers, and designers for fashion retail with explainable AI-based interventions during pre-season, in-season, and end-of-season decision making, so that eventually you increase your sell-through rate, and as a result, there is no less unsold inventory. Yeah. And this is sort of the bigger portfolio of things we offer, but I think I talked about forecasting, but let me just quickly surface all the different other things we have. So we kind of divide into three parts, what we call as the pre-season, in-season, and end-of-season. Yeah. So pre-season is when you're about to launch a new product, yeah? And this is where you are essentially doing what is the demand for this product, right? Once you're done, then you go to your planning, right? Essentially saying, okay, once you've forecasted the demand, can you tell me which product should go to which store and in what quantity? And that's the inventory allocation, yeah? And once the product hits the market, that is your in-season view. Now the product is in the market. Now you get actually more data from the market. And here you can do your replenishment inventory policies. And maybe after a few months, you realize, okay, the product is not really doing well. Now I have to intervene somehow. And this is where you do your markdowns, discounting, promotions, or if needed, interstore transfer. And end of the season is your season ends. And now your new stock arrives or new designs arrive. But you'd like to do a postmortem analysis, understand what is happening in the past season, and drive that as a season kind of insight for the next season. Though while it is laid out in a linear fashion, it's a circular thing, right? This keeps repeating in the fashion detail. Again, just the other elements we offer in our tool is also a visual dashboard. It's also an AI-infused product lifecycle tool which designers can come in. And this was the other use case I talked about, which is essentially around assortment planning, right? Which is a store-level hyper-local assortment planning. Once I have an accurate demand forecast for a product at a store, now you can use that to drive your planning. Tell me what set of products should I stock at each store so that the assortment is localized to the preferences of the customers shopping in that store. Yeah. So I think that's where I'll stop, and I'll sort of just stop at this brief slide, which is want to point out, and that fashion industry is considered to be the world's second largest polluter after oil and gas, and all that we do have a lot of implications for sustainability. And while we believe reducing unsold inventory is also one step into this, in this direction of making fashion more sustainable. Yeah. With that, I'll hand over to Jay to have some concluding remarks.
Thank you, Akash. So I think as Vikas pointed out, the problems of unsold inventory, how can we tap into the enterprise data, the dark data which is available. For example, we talked about the attributes which are very much available with the fashion houses. They have access to all the sales data that is available, customer feedback, or it could be any unstructured data that they have in the enterprise. So using that, using the AI models, we can try to
I think there's some technical glitch at Mr. Jayakrishnan's end. Mr. Vikas, you can take over.
Okay, so I think, yeah, so sorry, yeah, there's some. Yeah. Vijay, yeah, are you back? So,
yeah, I'm back, yeah. So I think the key message here is, right, with all these interventions, we can, the fashion houses can look at, having a consumer focused and kind of carbon responsible supply chain. That's the aim that they can look at, and AI is probably going to help them, in the whole journey. There are some questions. How has the pandemic impacted fashion purchases? I think we are working with different fashion retailers across the globe. And I think and how the fashion designing has changing is that we believe the fashion designers are becoming more aware of what they are designing, what they are putting into the market. And as Vikas talked about the attribute based explainability, we are seeing that people, certain things are not going to work, right? Why do you need to design? That intervention can happen in that stage itself. So that's how the future might evolve. With the power of data, the designers will have the capability to decide what exactly the consumer is going to consume and kind of really optimize, really the dead inventory. That's where the future is going to be. Vikas, anything you want to add to that question?
That's fine. I think if I want, I can take the next question. Okay, so I'll take the next question. So it's saying how important AI has become in manufacturing and fashion designing. What do you think is the future from this? Yeah. So I think our sort of takeaway from this project was that I think a lot of this, what I talked about, fashion designers already do this, merchandisers do this, but it's almost like a gut cop, right? Because they have worked in the industry for 5-10 years. They know what works, what does not work. But what these kind of tools enable is to kind of validate your gut by data, and you can do a little bit more sharper. Yeah, that's one message. The second is about scale, right? Which is essentially, okay, but typically a merchandiser designer can do this, but he has a sense of only one particular store, right? One particular area in Bombay, right? But now once you scale it up, if you have like hundreds or hundreds of stores in the country, and if you ask a human, like a merchandiser, to do it manually, that becomes a very tedious task, and that's where some of the kind of inefficiencies creep in, leading to less unsold inventory. So that's why some of the things which are can be automated by kind of data and AI. Yeah. Jay, you want to add anything? I think we have to.
Yeah, I think that is pretty much summed up well. I think we are at the top of the time, so. I think the interventions are across the table, right? Across the AI infusing, transforming the fashion supply chain. We have material discovery coming in to make reusable fashion, reducing greenhouse gases. That's how the future of fashion supply chain is going to be. And I think we are all going to be positively contributing to that.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, speakers. It was indeed a very insightful session. and a special thanks to our partners TeleSign, ShareChat, Blink Digital, and Nielsen. See you all in a bit for another exciting session.